we can open up to questions and comments from the public in the room. I should just sort of remind members of the public that questions must relate to matters on the agenda. Reasonably broad choice, but on the agenda. Any questions?
Thanks, Chair. Just in Sean Linton from the Health Service Journal. Just in relation to an item on the agenda in the action log, there was a meeting of the new Joint Finance Committee yesterday, and I think it was going to get the a refresh of the year-end forecast for the providers. I assume you can tell us now what that year-end forecast is.
In actual fact, the meeting was brought forward, so we were unable to have that discussion because the information was coming through to NHS Improvement today. So we weren't able to.
So you don't have a year-end forecast that you can share with us at the moment?
Information is currently coming through to NHS Improvement today, and we'll report formally to the public in that as part of our Q3 report.
And another question for you, Elizabeth, if that's okay, is the action log also mentions that you were going to look at the cost of making the extra beds available during the winter. I wondered if you could tell us what that cost was from the meeting yesterday.
Unfortunately, that's consistent, so we don't. The information around what's happened on capacity beds and elective income is coming through to us today from the provider sector. So as Ian opened in his opening statement, that's today's the deadline.
Well, you can't blame a journalist for trying, can you? But I'm going to try one last one if I can share with you.
We will indulge you with one last question on the basis
it's always the last question. This isn't an item on the agenda, but I think I have to ask it in public board about the Wirral Teaching Hospital and the investigation into Wirral that the NHS Improvement have commissioned. At the moment, NHSI has failed to commit to making this report public, and I don't think I need to rehearse the concerns that there are out there about what has gone on both internally with NHS Improvement but also at the Wirral Trust, and I can't imagine a way that the NHSI is going to avoid an embarrassing battle between us and you and the HSJ around public interest and information. So I'm hoping you can perhaps give us a commitment today that you will make that report public.
Well, in the spirit of transparency, we will definitely answer this question. Ian,
we will, and I should say that two points, Sean. First, I think it's worth just noting that as soon as we became aware of the seriousness of the allegations made, we immediately commissioned a full independent investigation that will review not only issues within the Trust, but also rightly will look at NHS Improvement's own handling of the situation. I think that's the first point. The second point is that transparency is obviously incredibly important to us here. I think there is a strong expectation that unless there are any issues that come out in the investigation that lead to legal advice that we shouldn't publish, that we will be publishing. And so there is a strong presumption of publication. And I think that is completely in line with the commitment to transparency and openness that I, as Chief Executive, want to apply here, but I suspect I speak on behalf of the board as well. So I would only comment that, in the earlier report, the implication was that if we didn't guarantee that there would be publication, that might not take place. I'm trying to give a signal here very clearly that there is a strong presumption of publication in line with our expectations on transparency. And I hope that answers your question very clearly, Sean.
It does, thank you very much.
My pleasure.
And I'm done now.
I mean, I'd add two things, if that's okay.
Absolutely.
The first one is that I think it is important that we create a safe space for people to speak to the independent investigator, and therefore it's right not to give a blanket commitment to publish everything in full at this stage. And we should be reserving our right to make sure that we're protecting people and encouraging them to really be honest and open. That's the first thing. And the second thing is, should there be anything that is critical and that NHS Improvement needs to learn from, we absolutely will be publishing that.
Absolutely right.
To ensure that we're being completely transparent on where we ourselves as a regulator need to learn.
Definitely.
Thank you.
Okay. I don't think there are questions from anyone else. in which case we should close this part of the meeting and ask members of the public to leave so that we can move on to confidential matters that we need to pick up. Thank you very much.